You think Terrence Crawford's going to open the next level next time?
What you mean, this level up here?
Yeah.
All depends on who he fights. See, the thing about pay-per-view and guys coming up is you. What made Pacquiao Mayweather so big was you had two fuses on both sides that were hot fuses for a long time. So either we have the two hot fuses or we have the out-of-country rivals, the Mexicans and the Puerto Ricans. You know, we have a rival like that, of course it comes. But he has to find somebody who's a real rival like they had.
You think the separation of weight and welterweight's going to be a problem?
No, that's not a problem, because now with guys like welterweights going to fight middleweights, how can you complain?
There's not that.
Crawford's on the ladder side.
That's not what I'm saying. That's not what I'm talking about. Uh-huh. If you got a welterweight moving to fight a middleweight, why can't a junior welterweight moving to fight a welterweight? Duh.
Is that what Crawford is facing? There's not that many big names at 140.
That's what the problem is. That's what the problem is. That's why he had to fight Paul Starr now. Yeah. Because there are not many big names there.
Can he handle some of the top 47s?
Of
and if so, which ones in particular do you think that he can beat right now?
Well, I ain't going to say who he can beat because I don't know for sure.
Or give a challenge to and just complicate things for
he
them.
He's going
to
make it complicated for any of them. Anybody in the top three right now, watch where he'll get him hell. He 157 tonight.
What about Errol Spence?
He'll give him hell too.
Ooh.
He's 157 tonight.
Why do you think that, Roy? Because a lot of people are real high on Errol.
Because he can box and he can fight off both sides. So you know, it's like with most guys, you have to figure out whether he has a good straight right hand or a good left hook or a good right uppercut or a good left uppercut or a good right body shot or a good left body shot. He's told the opposite. You got to figure all that out about him. Then you got to turn around and figure it out about him from the southpaw stance as well. So he's a much bigger puzzle than most guys.
How hard is it to fight a switch hitter?
It's very hard to fight one. Especially that knows how to switch and knows the proper time to switch. Look at Marvelous Marvin. He only really gave Ray hell at that time like that besides Tommy Hearn.
Hey, Roy, what impressed you the most about Terrence Crawford, what he did in there? He had a strong
The fact that he takes his time, figures these guys out, and uses whatever necessary to completely shut them down.
What could have Postol done differently?
Use his jab and punch more.
Yeah.
Use his jab, you're taller. Use your jab, but see, for some reason, I'm not claim to be the best guy in boxing. I'm not the most knowledgeable guy of everybody, but my point is, when you got a guy that's that tall, why do you jump over a foot in to reach the guy? Mm-hmm. When you're the tallest guy, why are you stepping a foot in? Every time he jumped a foot in. Mm-hmm. You're giving yourself to this guy. Why would you do that? You're never going to catch him jumping a foot in. All you got to do is step a little bit that way, and where you at? Right here. He's over there, he's over there, he's counting you. Where you at? You're right there in the hot water that your stupid self has stepped in. You can't do that in boxing. You feel me? You can't do that in boxing. Mm-hmm. Not calling Postol stupid, but I'm just saying, I'm just saying, like, on a whole in boxing, and the reason I said stupid self, because when my fighters do that, that's what I call them. Yeah. I put them out my gym for that. If you step too big on that front foot, and you can't find where that man, or you can't control your own range, get out my gym. Mm-hmm. I don't want to see that.